What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabid here, and today I'm going to show you how to CPU mine Zeph, which is the only way to really mine Zeph, unless you want to waste too much power on a GPU, to MiningOcean. As you can see, I've used this pool for quite some time. 322 Zeph has been paid from it so far. So looking at mining pool stats here, I originally started mining Zeph on EK pool. EK pool and MiningOcean were some of the original pools on Zeph. Now, EK pool was doing some shady stuff in the background. Numbers weren't matching up. We weren't getting the coins we were supposed to on other coins, and I wasn't getting it on Zeph according to my spreadsheet as well. And then we found out that, you know, things were not looking good. So then I moved over to MiningOcean, and I've been happy ever since. But the main thing is, we need to cause a little bit of more decentralization. We can see Hero Miners here is rocking almost 50% of the hash rate. Sometimes they do have 50 or more percent due to the fact that they are a prop pool, and that does allow a lot of hash rate rental services and solo miners to just jump on the pool, get a bunch of rewards, and then just jump off. Now, most miners prefer PPLNS, which is what MiningOcean actually does use. So a few things you might want to know about the pool is currently this is today's sponsor of this video. So thank you very much, MiningOcean, as well as the minimum payment is 0.2 Zeph. So depending on your hash rate, it could take, you know, a couple hours to a couple days to reach the minimum payout. You cannot change it, but you will be paid out every 0.2 Zeph and every 30 minutes once you do hit that minimum payout. So that's one thing to keep in mind. The pool fee is under 1% at 0.9, and they also reward a hashback bonus. So here you can see I'm only at 2% here because I have been mining other coins. I was upwards of 70 or 80%. You can see my total hashback paid. And what this is it pretty much reduces pool fees over time the more loyal you are to the pool, which PPLNS, you want to stay loyal here because you build up that share log and then you get full rate shares after that log is filled up. So here you do get, for mining on the pool, a slight discount in pool fees, and it slowly shows you how much you actually save in terms of extra Zeph being added to you over time. So if you don't yet have a wallet, you're going to need one, obviously, to get your receiving wallet address to mine your Zeph to. So we're going to come into GitHub here. All links will be down in the description. And scrolling down, the latest version for the GUI wallet is 1.02. Now, the ones newer in this is just some CLI wallet fixes as well as a mining pool. If you're running mining pool, you're obviously going to have to be on the latest one right there. But for the GUI wallet, which is nice and easy for a lot of you, it is the 1.02. So scroll down and you will see Zephyr Wallet version 1.02 Windows. Download this one. Now, if you do want to run your own node alongside this so that you can sync up your own chain and everything on your own PC, run a little more decentralized, which is recommended. That's what you do when it comes to Monero, unless you want to run remote here. But you only have the option to run remote if you download this. If you want to do your own node, you will also have to download the Windows CLI version and run the Zephyr D file there, and that'll start your own node that way because it is not mixed in with the GUI wallet currently. Maybe in a future update it will be, but right now it currently isn't. I think they should add the two together as one download. That way you have the option of one download instead of downloading both, because a lot of people were asking me about this and it doesn't have it built into the GUI wallet. All right, so once you do download your wallet and do all the seed phrase stuff, just like you do with any other crypto wallet out there, you're going to need a miner. Now, I recommend XMRig for any algorithm that it supports. This is RandomX. XMRig supports RandomX, so that's what we're going to roll with. The latest version is 6.210. It was released 3 weeks ago. Simply scroll down and download either the MSVC version or the GCC. Now, I still have to test both of these individually. It does sound like one does a little bit better on RandomX, where the other one does a little bit better on Ghost Rider. I didn't really notice a difference myself when it came to RandomX, but I'm going to do a lot more testing moving forward. So right now, I'm just using the MSVC, but choose any one that you want. All right, guys, so now we got to figure out our connection to the pool. And I'm in Canada here, obviously, but I do like to use the US stratum here. But up top, we can see North America, USZephyr.miningocean.org. So we're going to copy this over, right click, copy, and then we got to figure out what port to use. So the difficulty for RandomX coins, usually you take your hash rate and times it by 30, because you want to try to get 2 to 3 shares every 30 seconds, and that seems to be optimal here. So example, a 7900X that is doing 18,000 hashes or 18 kilohash, you take that, times it by 30, that is about 540,000 for a 7900X. As you can see here, that's even more than the high-end hardware. Now, I just use the mid-range usually, so 5442 is what I'm going to use here, but it is recommended to do that times 30 thing if you want. Now, what happens if you pick a very small low-end? You're going to find a lot of rejected shares right off the get-go, and it's going to look bad. Some pools do ban you if you're doing that because it does bog down the pool a little bit, but over time, it will just swap over because this pool is variable difficulty, so it'll auto-adjust in the first place. So just using something like the low to mid ends, if you're on Ryzen's, just use the mid end range type of CPUs here as a default, and you should be okay. Now, MiningOcean uses your password as your worker name, not after your wallet address. So keep that in mind as well. Just to get an idea based on the pool, you can go down to the auto config gen here, go to the worker name, put in a bunch of gobbledygook like so, generate the config, and we can see in our dash P here, that's where it showed up. So this is gonna be your worker name in these parentheses here based on your bat file. All right, so we now have a wallet. So we have an address to mine to, and we know everything we need to know about connecting to the pool. So now we're going to set up our miner, and XMRig actually has two ways to set up and mine. One is through a bat file configuration. The other is through a JSON file configuration. And we're going to run through both right quick, starting with the JSON. So to set up the config here, we're going to simply right click on the JSON, hit edit, and then scroll down until we do see where we add everything in. Mine's already set up because I've been mining, but you're going to come down to here to where it says pools, algo, coin, and all this. And it's not going to have this RX0 by default. It's going to be blank or just say null. So you're going to have to add that in separately. So what we're going to do here, randomX is RX0. So we're just going to go RX/0. And you're going to have to add quotations on both sides of this. If it is not there, your miner will not work. You'll see shutdowns and all sorts of other weird things. So make sure you do have your quotations in here after you set your algo. So once your algo is set, we got to go down to URL, and this is where we're going to put in our pool parameters. So here is US Zephyr miningocean.org, followed by semicolon and our port 5342, which we looked at earlier in this on how to find out what to use. And then our password is going to be our worker name. It's not by our actual user address. So we're going to set our password here, Rabid Workstation. Obviously, we need to mine to an address. Right here beside user, in between the quotations, you're going to copy in your actual Zeph wallet address, not followed by a period or any type of worker name, because we already did that in our password. So this is what your JSON config should look like, obviously with your wallet address and your worker name here, followed by, depending on the hardware you're using, with a different port. But you'll probably be okay using this port directly. So this is all you got to do here. Simply hit file and then save, and you should be good to go. We're going to close this out. Now, XMRig, you want to run this as an administrator, so you can simply right click this, run as admin, or go down to properties, compatibility, and make sure you check on run this program as an administrator, because if you start using bat files, which is the way I prefer to do it, because you can see I have RTM Ocean, you know, Rehex here, Rabid Proxy, I have all sorts of different bat files. It makes it very easy to switch over to different pools and coins instead of having to reconfigure this JSON config each time. I prefer the bat file method over the config, and that's why you're going to want this to auto set. That way, when it runs this, it tells this to run, and then it'll run it as an administrator automatically. All right, so now we're going to set up a bat file, and this is the preferred way I like to mine. Now, by default, obviously, you don't have all these presets kind of in here, but you can go up to the pool mine example, right click this, edit, and just copy this right here. Here you can see that. So I'm just going to right click this. We're going to copy that. I'm going to close this out, and then I'm just going to go into anything else here. So in this case, you know, you can see Zeph start. We're going to edit this, and I would erase all this and then just simply paste the one in we just copied. So you don't need the echo off, but it's just a default to get this in here. Once you get that copied in here, I'm going to close it and not save it because I already have mine set up. And you're going to come into something like this. And now you just adjust your parameters. So here you can see this is where we're going to put our pool. So the dash O here is your mining pool. So you're going to paste that in right behind that spot there. Algorithm is RX0. So make sure you have the RX0. You can see there's no quotations needed here, so you can just have your RX/0 and then dash U. This is your wallet address, and then you got your dash P. This is your worker name. And then what I also like here, and it's easier, you can do this in the JSON as well, but you got to do a lot more steps to set threads in that. But here you can just go dash dash threads equals, and then however many threads you want to run. This is a 7950X, 32 threads. I am limiting 4 threads down to 28. That way I have a lot of stuff in the background. I can continue to record videos, edit and stuff like that while I'm still mining. So I do limit my threads here to 28, and it makes it much easier to do that if that's something you want to do in the bat file. Now, once you're done with that, you simply save it and then you double click on Zephyr Start. Now, because we set this to run as administrator every time, you can see what I mean. When I double click this, it's going to ask, yes, admin privileges. And now admin is going to run this with your hash rate boost, which is running MSR mod and all that. If it is saying failed to apply MSR mod, simply shut it off and try it again. If that doesn't work and it's your very first time running XMRig, you will have to reboot your computer and then run it as administrator again. And it should apply that MSR mod. And you can see we're getting 100% huge pages here on both ends of the spectrum here. So we are getting that hash rate boost. Without it, you are losing probably, I think, 5 to 10%. All right, so now that we're done with Windows, we're going to jump into HiveOS and show you how to set this up. So the first thing you are going to want to do is you're going to have to set up your wallet. So go into whatever farm you are mining on with your CPUs, go into wallets here, and then hit add wallet. Go to type coin and ticker, simply hit ZE, Zeph should pop up. It is added into HiveOS by default now. And then simply paste your wallet address in here. And then name the wallet whatever you want. You know, whether it's your GUI wallet, or maybe it's your web wallet, or maybe your exchange name wallet. Put whatever you want, and that's what will show up so you can kind of see what wallet you're mining to if you do have multiple wallets. Once you're done that, we're going to go into flight sheets and actually set up the flight sheet to begin mining to MiningOcean. So the first thing we're going to do is go to coin here. We're going to type in Zeph, and this is based on whatever wallet you did set up. As we know, Zeph is added in by default, so we're simply going to click on Zeph, select our wallet, node easy. So this is my GUI node type of wallet. That's how I named it, and I know what it is. Pool, we're going to come into here. There are no pools in here by default, so we are going to have to configure that in the miner. We're going to select our miners, put XM, and XMRig should show up. You do want XMRig new. And then we're going to name this flight sheet. So I'm going to name this flight sheet video test. And then we're going to set up our miner config. So the first things I like to hammer through this, you want to turn on your CPU. Step number one, turn on that CPU. So many people forget about this and they set everything up and they just wondering, how come my flight sheet's not working? It's broken. I can't mine. What's going on? They didn't turn on their CPU. So simply click this, make sure it's green and it says CPU on right here. Your CPU is now off. So turn that on. Next up, we're going to pick our algorithm. So we're going to need random X here. Put in random and random X XMR will pop up. Wallet template, click there. Wallet.workername. Now remember, we need our password for our worker name. So we're simply gonna copy this, or I guess cut it out, remove that. We're gonna go to our password, put our worker name right there. And we are gonna want huge pages, click that there. CPU configuration, click that there. And now we need our pool parameters to MiningOcean. So just like how we kind of went over everything earlier on in this video, I'm gonna use the US West here. So we're gonna right click, copy this, and I'm gonna wanna use just the mid-range stratum here, 5342. So we're gonna come into here, simply put that in there, semicolon 5342, and that is it. Our CPU mining rig is now set up to mine Zeph to MiningOcean. So we're gonna apply these changes here and create that flight sheet. All right, so our flight sheet is made. Now, depending how many rigs you have, you might just wanna go into your single worker if that's all you have. You go down to flight sheets, scroll on down, and then it will be the first flight sheet. The latest flight sheet you made will be the first one after the star. So this is our flight sheet right here. You simply click this and send it to the moon. Now, if you have multiple rigs like we see here, We're going to go back into my farm. I'm simply going to click all right here and then just get rid of the ones that actually aren't running right now and turned off. So we're going to get rid of that. These aren't running yet. They still have to be built. And then we're going to come up to the top here and select flight sheet. From here, we're going to pick our coins. I'm just going to find Zeph wherever it is hiding right here. And then here you can see here. Oh, wait, I forgot. I was going to use my Node Easy because that's what I'm used to using all the time. We made the test video one. So we're going to scroll down till I find my test video made one, wherever that is. Okay, I can't find it. I'm lost. Oh, right here is the very first one. I guess I could have picked that. I'm blind. So video test. So I'm simply going to click on that and then I'm going to say apply, and it's going to apply that flight sheet to every single worker at the same time. This is why I really love HiveOS. I can move around from coins to pools to anything at, you know, three clicks. Click, click, pick my pool, click, done. And, you know, that's why I really love HiveOS for CPU mining. We just do a couple refreshes up top just to make sure everything is switching over all right. The dual epic is taking its sweet time. It does take a little longer than everything else, but we can see all our other rigs is already switched over. Let's do another refresh here, and now we can see the hash rate. So everything is now up and running and connected to MiningOcean. You can simply go right back into the MiningOcean dashboard here if you have it saved or not. So we're going to click on MiningOcean here. Go to my worker statistics, and it's loading up, and you can see. And now it is very fast. Your rigs do detect at the pool somewhere, I think it's less than a minute. That way, if you check the pool and you see your rig is offline, it's very fast into telling you if something is on or offline here. Well, there we have it, guys. Hopefully, this video did help you up and get up and mining Zeph to the MiningOcean mining pool. It is a pool I have used for quite some time and I do enjoy it. Also, help out the network's decentralization. Hopefully Zephyr goes to the moon. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.